Yeah, so in today's video, we are going to practice how to find the total resistance of a circuit. In finding the total resistance of a circuit, there are two things you need to consider. First of all, you need to consider two resistors at a time. And then secondly, you need to know the type of connection between the two resistors. Resistors can either be connected in series or in parallel. And in today's video, we are going to solve a lot of examples. We are going to practice how to find the total resistance of a circuit. Moving ahead, let's consider a circuit diagram where we have two resistors, that is R1 and R2, connected in series. And then we also have a voltage source, that is VIN, connected across the two resistors. And let's say we have R1 to be 2 ohms, and then we also have R2 to be 4 ohms. We realize that the voltage source drives current, say I, through the two resistors from the positive terminal and then back to the negative terminal. Now, because we have the same current flowing through the two resistors, of course, we can see that the two resistors are connected in series. Now, for series connection of resistors, we have the same current flowing through the two resistors, irrespective of the value of their resistance. Secondly, whenever a current flows through a resistor, there is a voltage drop. And then the voltage drop is equal to the current that flows through the resistor multiplied by the value of the resistance. So that in this case, we have two resistors here. And so the voltage drop across R1 will be equal to I multiplied by R1. And then the voltage drop across the second resistor, that is R2, will also be equal to I multiplied by R2. Now in this case, we have R1 to be 2 ohms. And so we have I multiplied by 2, which is equal to 2i. And then we also have R2 to be 4. And so we have I multiplied by 4, which is equal to 4i. Now we realize that we have two different voltage drops. That is V1 is equal to 2i. And then we have V2 to be equal to 4i. This tells us that for series connection of resistors, the voltage drops across the respective resistors are not the same. In summary, we realize that for series connection of resistors, we have the same current flowing through the respective resistors, and then the voltage drop across the two resistors are also different. Now, the total resistance of resistors connected in series is given by their sum. So that we have RT, that is the total resistance, is equal to R1 plus R2. Now, in this case, we have R1 to be 2 ohms, and then we have R2 to be 4 ohms. And so we have 2 plus 4, which gives us 6 ohms. So our total resistance for this particular circuit is equal to 6 ohms. And also, in a situation where we have 3 resistors, then the total resistance is given by RT equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now let's talk about parallel connection of resistors. This is where we have resistors connected such that we have different currents flowing through them. Let's consider a circuit where we have a 2 ohm resistor connected in parallel with a 4 ohm resistor. And then we also have a voltage source here that is VIN. Now realize that the voltage source drives current through the entire circuit. Now we have current I moving in this direction to this point, that is to the junction A. Now at junction A, we see that, or we realize that the current will divide so that we have I1 flowing in this direction. And then we also have R2 also flowing in that direction. Now, because we have two different currents flowing through the two resistors, we conclude that the two resistors are connected in parallel. Secondly, we see this applied voltage being expressed across the 2 ohm resistor and also being expressed across the 4 ohm resistor. This tells us that for parallel connection of resistors, we have the same applied voltage being expressed across them. Thirdly, because we can go through this loop without passing through any other circuit element except for the two resistors, then of course the two resistors are connected in parallel. Now, the total resistance for two resistors connected in parallel is given by this formula, that is RT equals R1 multiplied by R2 divided by R1 plus R2. In this case, we have our R1 to be 2 ohms, and then we have our R2 to be 4 ohms. Therefore, the total resistance RT is equal to 2 multiplied by 4 divided by 2 plus 4, which gives us 8 divided by 6. And then we have 1.33 ohms. In summary, for parallel connection of resistors, we have different currents flowing through the respective resistors. And then secondly, the voltage across the two resistors are the same. And then thirdly, we can go through the loop without passing through any other circuit element except for the two resistors. So now let's try to solve an example. In this example, we have three resistors connected in the circuit. We have the 0.1 ohm resistor, we have the 2 ohm resistor, and we also have the 0.5 ohm resistor. Now realize that the 2 ohm resistor and then the 0.5 ohm resistor are connected in parallel. This is because we can go through this loop without passing through any other circuit element except for the two resistors. Now, whenever we also have a current, approaching this junction, we are going to have the current dividing so that we have part of the current flowing through this direction and the other part also flowing through that direction. Now, because we have two separate currents flowing through the respective resistors, then of course the resistors are connected in parallel. Now, moving ahead to find the equivalent resistance of the two resistors, then we are going to use this formula. Now, we have RT prime to be equal to 2 multiplied by 0.5 divided by 2 plus 0.5, and then we have 1 divided by 2.5, which gives us 0.4 ohms. Now let's redraw the circuit to make things simpler for us to analyze. And so we have our 0.1 ohm resistor, this time connected in series with the equivalent resistance, that is 0.4 ohms. So the total resistance for the entire circuit, or for the two resistors, using this formula is equal to 0.1 plus 0.4, which means that we have RT to be 0.5 ohms. That means that the total resistance for the entire circuit is equal to 0.5 ohms. Now let's solve our second example. In our second example, we have four resistors connected in the circuit. We have our 4 ohm resistor, we have our 2 ohm resistor, and we also have 2 1 ohm resistors. Now, for us to find the effective or the total resistance of the circuit, we realize that we have this resistor in series with this resistor, and so their equivalence will be equal to, let's say we have RT prime, then we are going to have 1 plus 1, because they are connected in series, and then we have their equivalence to be 2 ohms. Now we realize that the combination of these two resistors is in parallel with this 2 ohm resistor. And so we can say that then RT prime prime is also equal to 2 multiplied by these 2 divided by 2 plus 2, which gives us 4 divided by 4, and then we have 1 ohm. Now let's try to redraw the circuit again. And so we have our 4 ohm resistor connected in parallel with the 1 ohm resistor. Now, because we have the two resistors connected in parallel, then we can say that RT, which is the total resistance, is equal to 4 multiplied by 1 divided by 4 plus 1. And then we have 4 divided by 5, which is 0.8 ohms. So the total resistance for this circuit is equal to 0.8 ohms. In our third example, we realize that we have 5 resistors connected in the circuit. Now, fast forward, we see that we have the 6 ohm resistor connected in parallel with the 3 ohm resistor. So they are equivalents. Let's say we have RT prime is equal to 6 multiplied by 3 divided by 6 plus 3, and then we have 18 divided by 9, which gives us 2 ohms. Now realize that the combination of these two resistors is in series with a 2 ohm resistor. And so we can have RT prime prime to be equal to 2 plus 2, which gives us 4 ohms. Now let's try to redraw the circuit. We will have our 4 ohms resistor in series with our 4 ohm resistor, that is this, and also in series with the 8 ohms resistor. We realize here that we have the three resistors connected in series because we will have the same current flowing through them. Therefore, the total resistance for the entire circuit is equal to 4 plus 4 plus 8, so that we have RT to be equal to 16 ohms.